Hello everyone, welcome to Abhipedia, powered by Abhimanyu IAS. This is 24th lecture of Science and Tech Value Addition series with Dr. Vivek Rana. And topic for today's lecture is from Oceanography. I'll be covering Smudrayaan from prelims point of view, which is likely to be a major mission of 2022, just like we had covered Gaganyaan mission, in which we are aiming to send 4 Vyomnauts into lower Earth's orbit. In same way, this mission is about sending 3 individuals deep down in deep sea for sea exploration. So I'll be covering what this Smudrayaan mission is, what is likely to be the major significance and objectives of this mission, and likely themes which you should cover from prelims point of view, and like always a practice question from this oceanography theme. So let's start today's lecture on Smudrayaan. So first of all, we have to understand that which is the key organization which is spearheading this project, because this is a quite ambitious project and it has a firm backing from government. And if you were following this year's budget, Ministry of Earth Sciences has received almost 2000 crores extra as compared to last year. So this is, which roughly translates to 8% jump. So this ministry has now sufficient funds to spearhead such projects, and this project will be spearheaded by none other than NIOT, National Institute on Ocean Technology, which is based at Chennai. So make sure you don't get confused with the oceanography organizations. Like examiner, if is framing a factual question, may switch this organization with the NIO, National Institute of Oceanography. So make sure you are clear in your mind that this is the NIOT project. Now, what is the likely objective which they are aiming at? So this is a submersible vehicle which will be created indigenously and will be sent deep down in sea for deep sea mining. As we know, there are polymetallic nodules deep inside, and which could be of great economic as well as strategic significance for country like India. So this is one of the ambitious project which will be likely to be done in 21-22, which coincides with the 75th anniversary of India's independence, just like Gaganyaan. Okay. And we are planning to send at least 3 individuals in the deep sea. Now, what is the key feature for which this Smudrayaan is likely to be remembered, because that is going to be the major highlight, that this submersible vehicle has potential to go deep into sea almost 6 kilometers, that is 6000 meters, because a typical submarine which we cover in our defense lectures are generally go 200 meter deep. So you can imagine going deep into almost 6 kilometers in the deep sea and exploring the typical environment as well as the economic parameters which can be utilized by the country. So that is going to be the key highlight. And another key highlight is that it can stay there for 72 hours. So you can say almost 3 individuals, if they would be trained, and eventually they would likely to be stay for almost 2 to 3 days in deep sea. So that is likely to be the key highlight of the mission. And the budget for the time being is being 200 crores for this pilot project, because eventually this sum is likely to increase in the coming years once this operationalizes. And because ministry, as I have said, has sufficient funds in its kitty to execute such bold projects. And now let's discuss the overall significance, because once this mission is accomplished, what is India aiming at? So far, deep sea mining is one of the key areas which is being accomplished by only developed world. India is likely to be the first developing country to do this mission on its own. And another key advantage is generally oceanic research vessels or submersible vehicles which are used are of foreign nation. But this time, this project Smudrayaan is going to be an indigenous mission. So in your syllabus, indigenization of technology is a key theme. So this theme can be asked even as a reference in mains questions as well. So you should be thorough with the overall significance that this is going to make India enter in select group of countries which have done deep sea missions almost 5 to 6 kilometers deep in the sea. And apart from that, this mission is has economic and strategic significance, because once you are going deep, under UN Clause 1982, United Nations Convention, Law of Sea, International Seabed Authority has allocated almost 75,000 square kilometer in deep Indian Ocean basin. So we are likely to encash that opportunity, and because in deep sea there are polymetallic nodules which are potentially rich in manganese as well as other rare earth metal like cobalt, nickel, which can have a larger strategic significance for e-vehicles, electronics, batteries and whatnot. So it's not just the exploration mission, it has some economic and strategic significance, because a country which will have sufficient reserves of these elements is likely to get additional advantage in the electronic revolution which is impending, because 2020 to 2030 is the decade in which e-vehicle technology is going to be critical. Early starters are likely to be the key advantage as well. So this mission is likely to dominate headlines once the funds and the projects gets going, and it's likely as ambitious as our Gaganyaan mission. Okay, so this is what we had for Samudrayaan. You are now thorough with what Samudrayaan is. Now, what are the other themes which as a general studies student you should cover while preparing for this topic, because it's not enough to just know the major theme of Samudrayaan. You just, as I have mentioned about polymetallic nodule, this is the first theme you should study a little bit deep. Why are they called manganese nodule? What are these exactly? Because they are almost potato size, small iron oxide concentrations which are in concentrics, and they have rich layers of other elements as well in varying quantities. So make sure you just go through the composition which is given in your booklet as well. You could make the utilize, there is a specific paragraph, and then you should also try to differentiate the roles of various oceanic research organizations which are under Ministry of Earth Sciences, because I have mentioned this is spearheaded by NIOT. So make sure you just go through the broad functions which are performed by National Institute of Ocean Technology, Chennai, National Institute of Oceanography, Goa, because these are at times interchange, or at times UPSC is trying, may ask what is the basic mandate of these bodies. Then the one another theme which you could cover is UN clause as well, because I have given a certain reference of role of International Seabed Authority, United Nations Convention, Law of Sea, what is the territorial limit, what is the exclusive economic zone of 200 nautical miles. You should be totally clear in your revision part. And also some ocean research vessels which have been in news, you could go through that. Like India has a rich fleet of ocean research vessels. Generally their names are like Sagar, there is Sagar Kanya, there is Sagar Kavach, there is Sagar, or recently Sindhu Sadhana was commissioned, which is the first indigenous research vessel. So make sure you are thorough with the all these, there is Sagar Paschimi, Purvi, okay, so all these things, because at times nuclear submarines as well as the common research vessels are commonly interchanged. And finally, a practice question on this basic theme. I have given, you have to choose the incorrectly matched pair among the given options, and the first option IND-ARC. This has already been asked in UPSC prelims some years back. It is underwater observatory function in Arctic region, and so first option is correct. In the B option, there is Himadri. We have to understand this is the only functional resource station of India in Arctic region. So B statement is also once again correct. In the third option is a familiar lines once again Bharti, which is India's currently functional Antarctic resource station. Apart from with historically we had Dakshin Gangotri, then we created Maitri, and now this is the newest one which has been created. So even the C option is correct. So eventually you have to pick the last D option, none of the above. So this is what we have in today's lecture on Samudrayaan. I'll be back soon with another science and tech value addition lecture. I hope this session was useful. Keep following. Thank you very much.